Today, let me see about the electronic components. Okay. Nowadays, we are familiar with the electronics and its components. So, before entering into the topic, we have to see about this basic concept and what are the active passive components mainly involved in the electronic circuits, and particularly about this one of these components, resistors and capacitors. Okay. So nowadays we are using so many equipments using the concept of the electronics. So the familiar things, nowadays we are using the cellular phone. So cellular phone is mainly are constructed with these components of electronics. Another that, so you know, we are using the radio sets, TVs and music systems and TVs. And modern technologies using where so many equipments, video cameras and still cameras, video cameras, etc. There are so many things we are using these concepts of electronics. So we may simply tell that without electronic we could not live in our country. So we are practiced with this electronics and its technology nowadays. Okay, what is electronics? Okay. So in a lower class, we are studying about this electronics, and now in every day, every place, you are seeing all these words, using these words, electronics, okay. So what is electronics? Okay, what is the physical definition of this electronics? So electronics is nothing but the study of flow of charge of electrons in the various materials, okay, such as the semiconductors or some other materials. So the flow of charge is nothing but electron flow. So we mainly tell about the electron charge only, okay. So the flow of charge in any materials, whether it may be conductor or whether it may be resistor or whether it may be capacitor, whatever may be. So simply you may tell that the flow of charge in this material, okay, or conductors or insulators or etc. Okay, electronics. So nowadays we are using the so many electronic circuits, okay. So what are the familiar circuits we have seen about in our day to life or in our classes or our subjects? Okay, so we are studying about familiar in this particular circuits like rectifier, oscilloscope, then radio and TV transmitters and receivers. Okay, rectifiers. Okay, so rectifier is a very important term, okay. So in your previous class we have studied about the rectifiers, that is a diode. The diode is example, diode is one of the rectifier. So what is rectification, do you know? Okay, so yes, conversion, okay, AC into DC. So in alternately we may tell that another inverse term words is inverter, okay. The process is inversely transferred, okay. So that is the difference between and the rectifier and inverters, okay. Then oscillator. So we have studied about the so many oscillators, okay. What is the oscillator? Oscillating the waves, okay. That may be called feet or constable or bicycle, whatever may be. There are so many oscillators in this now the electronic circuits. Then radio and TV and receivers. So all are made up of electronic and its circuits, okay. So all before constructing these circuits, another important pre-circuits is here, that is a electrical power supply. The power supply is very important. If you give any potential to any circuits, the power supply is very important. Power supply. What is the power supply? So power supply is nothing but whether it may be AC power supply or DC power supply. Okay. So in any, if you give any potential to any circuits, the power supply is very important, okay. Nothing but if we construct a very simple power supply, is one transformer and rectifier capacity is enough, okay. So there are the using this power supply, we may, if you decrease the current or increase the current, whatever may, so according to our necessity and requirements you may construct this power supplies. Then active and passive components. Okay, so these are the electronic components nowadays we are using day to life. Okay, what is the history of this electronics? In those days, we are using these vacuum tubes only. Do you know about the vacuum tubes? What is a vacuum tubes? Okay, so that is nothing but that is a flow of charge, electrons flow. The same principle is applied. So the vacuum tubes, before discovering the semiconductive material, we were using these vacuum tubes. So one of the scientists, okay, the germanium bipolar transistors is discovered 50 years before. So the first semiconducting material is discovered by this scientist Baden, Schottky and Brayton and Bellows. Okay, see, these are these inventors of this germanium bipolar transistors in the year of 1947. Okay, so after the era or century of this, the vacuum tubes period, the semiconducting materials is widely discovered. So what are semiconducting materials? Silicon and germanium. Okay, so using this, the first bipolar transistors in the year of 1947. Okay, just we have to see about the milestones of the electronics. In the 18th century, first the solid state rectifier is invented. After that, one triode vacuum tube is invented on the year of 1906. So in the period of the 1907 to 27, the radio circuit is widely developed using this convention of the diodes and triodes. Okay, so what is the purpose of these radio circuits? So radio circuit is nothing but to give the information to others, to transmit the data to others by the way of voice. Okay, so in the Second World War around, the radio circuit is mainly developed. So there are so many radio circuits. So the using the triode diodes, if you give the potential, other than some of the radio circuits, ham radios are developed in those days. In the 1947, another scientist, Baldwin and Brayton laboratories, they invented the bipolar transistor. That is the first period of this, the invention of this semiconducting material. So after that, the invention is widely developed. In the year of 1952, the commercial bipolar transistor is discovered. So what is the purpose of the commercial bipolar transistor? Using this transistor, we may construct these any radio circuits, some electronic circuits, okay, whatever may be. So then another that using the invention of this bipolar transistor in 1956, that same scientist got this Nobel Prize. After that, 1958, okay, the semiconducting materials widely developed using some other scientist, Kilby. Okay, after that, 1961, and the semiconducting materials is further increasing this their area. 1961, in 1963, IEEE form. Okay, and IRE, what is Institute of Electrical and Electronic Engineering? Yeah, one of these organizations formed by one of the scientists, merger. So this IEEE is combined with Institute of Radio Engineering and American Institute of Electronics and Engineering. So these are the organizations mainly discover this field of only about the electronics. So what, using this such commons, how do we develop the electronics area? So that are the organization IEEE, IREAE, mainly develop that area. Then using this, the organizations of the year 1963, in the 1960s, first commercial IC operational amplifier is developed and constructed. So operation amplifier, do you know about the operation amplifiers? So the familiar IC number is IC741, okay, operation amplifier. Okay, in 555 there are two operation amplifiers are simultaneously inbuilt in the IC. Okay, then later that, so the electronic semiconducting material is widely developed year by year. In the year of 71, the microprocessor is introduced. After that, the invention of the microprocessor, the computer field is widely developed. Okay, so using this microprocessor, we are constructing so many 8087 microprocessor in the different bits and memory chips, etc., etc. Nowadays, you are using the so many processor in different frequencies are widely developed. So these are the milestones of these electronics. Okay. Then, using these electronics, so electronics, circuits and components. We know about these electronics and circuits is common. Okay. So in the electronic circuits, generally we are using these resistors and capacitors, inductors. So we generally, and transistors also you are using. Okay. Using these components combined with circuits, we may use these the circuits for amplification and transfer the data. So in every circuits, one inputs, one circuit, then one outputs here. Okay. So inputs, circuits containing is employed by using this power supply. Okay. Then you are allowed to come to our topic. Classification of the electronic components. Okay. So there are the components, electronic components may be classified into two manner. One is the active components and another one is passive components. So the active components, simply you may tell the semiconducting devices such as diodes and transistors. These are the first invented semiconducting materials, diode and transistor. Using the diode, we may using the rectification, okay, or whatever may be. In the, there are the one, sometimes it is called as, generally it is called as junction diode. You are familiar, the word. The, okay, PN junction diode, the transistor. So there are the, you are familiar with the transistors, the three terminals, one is base, collector and emitter, base emitter junction and base collector, the junction, PN junctions are, there are two PN junctions are in the transistor, okay. So what is the uses of these active components such as diodes and transistors? Okay, so the diode and transistors are generally used for this amplification, rectification, signal generation, changing energy from one form to another form, and the handling the power. Okay, so what is this? So using this diode, we may construct power supply. Yeah. Then using the transistor, you may construct the one amplifier for the amplification purpose. Okay. Well, other than that, so some apart from that, the active components, some examples are display devices and voltage and current sources are the active components. Then what are the basic components? Resistors, capacitors, inductors. Okay. So these are the passive components. In addition, the diodes and polarized capacitors was installed for specified way. So it is not generally we may not use, but specify some according to the some specified circuits you may using that. So what is the passive components? Okay. So the control of the current direction on flow and the particular desirable direction in the circuits. So the passive components themselves they may not use. Okay. Is for individual purposes. So the passive components will combined with these IT components, it may use for amplifications and rectification, etc. Okay. So the only you use, we may not using only the passive components for some other purposes. So using passive and IT components combined with, you may use all these purposes. Okay. Okay, in this chapter, we mainly deal about this resistance, resistor, and their types. Okay, and how to calculate the resistor value in practical manner, how to measure the resistor value in the multimeters, okay, and so on. Okay, so this is a picture of this electronic components. Before, in those days, the vacuum tubes and discrete transistors, very large scale, small scale integration of the integrated circuits and VLSI surface mount circuits. Okay, so the small scale integration is nothing but, so it is a semiconducting material after the developing of this diode transistors. So if you consider the one IC, that is small scale integration, so in every IC, there's a multiple number of transistors and diodes and power sources are inbuilt. And suppose if you consider the VLSI surface mount circuits, that is, it may be considered as one of the processor. So in a processor, there are multiple number of array numbers of ICs are inbuilt. Okay, these are the wide development of this electronics. So this is a one picture. It is taken from one museum. So what is this? These are the picture of this vacuum tubes. Okay, vacuum tubes. Later day we called as valves. Triode, pentode. Okay, there are so many types of valves. Then resistors. The common name is resistor. By these words, we may calculate the value of this resistance. Resistance is the common name which is used for this resistor. Okay, what is the resistor? We have already know about the active and passive components. So nothing but is only a passive components. Okay, so the resistor will resist the flow of current. Okay, when a resistor is connected in a circuit, the current flow through this resistance, according to the value of the resistance, the current will be limited. Okay, so the main purpose of the resistance is current flowing in the circuit, limit the current flowing in the circuit, or control the current flowing in the circuit. So according to our necessity, according to our requirements, we may using the resistance. Okay, suppose if in a circuit a small amount of current is needed, according to your requirements you may put some, according to the proper value of the resistance fixed at that place, so the current will be limited. So the unit of the resistance is ohms. Okay, here one of the scientists was invented the resistance as his name is George Ohm. So using his name, the ohm symbol or ohm is a that is a unit of this resistance. Okay, so the according to the ohms, he framed the law, that is the ohms law, that is the relation connecting voltage, current and the resistance. Okay, normally if you see the resistance, there are two terminals. Okay, in your laboratory you may see the resistance. Okay, two terminals. So according to this, the two terminals, the passive two terminals, the potential is measured. Okay, the electrical resistance value should be identified. If you connect this resistance in the voltmeter, we may calculate this value. Okay, the ratio of this voltage applied across the resistance terminals is the intensity of the current through this circuit. That is called the resistance. So the resistance relation connecting according to the Ohm's law, so V is equal to IR. This formula is familiar. That is for Ohm's law. We are familiar. So voltage, current, and the resistance. Okay. If a current carrying conductor, according to the Ohm's law, voltage proportional to current. V is equal to IR. Then what are the types of the resistor? There are the two types. One is fixed resistor. Another one is variable resistor. So what is the fixed resistor? Okay. So nowadays we are using the fixed resistor in the particular electronic circuits. If you see the electronic fixed resistors in our laboratory, there are so many types of fixed resistors. One is Karman composite resistor, another one is film resistor, and another one is wire wound resistor. Last one is resistance of wire. Then variable resistor. So rheostat, potentiometer, thermistor, immistor, varistor, and photo resistors. So let me see one by one of the first, the fixed resistor. So first let me see about this Karman composite resistor. Okay, so we are using the Karman composite resistors in the so many electronic circuits. So how they make this Karman composite resistor? So it is nothing but a carbon mixer combined with some impurities. It's made up of this Karman composite resistor. Using these impurities added, we may limit the value of this resistance. Okay, according to the value of the resistance, whether it be 1 ohm, 2 ohm, or 10 ohm, or 47 ohms, whatever may be. So the value of this resistance should be calibrated according to the mixture of this carbon and then some impurities added on it. Okay, it is very cheap material. Okay, if you if you buy your own resistor in the market, the cost is around 1 rupee down, that's all, okay? Because using the carbon composite materials, so the resistor, the cost is very cheap, okay? Then it's having the large tolerances, okay? So the carbon composite resistors, nowadays we are using this carbon composite resistors. Then next one is film resistors, the film. So here the same method is taken as in the carbon composite. Instead of this carbon composite, we are using the resistive films. So the films having the resistive films according to the thickness and the size and some according to the different types of material. So may construct the different types of ohms using these film type resistor. Okay. So if you increase the value of this resistance, so the resistor, the increasing the desired thickness of this deposited film. So that due to changing the thickness of the deposited films by changing, so you may increase the values or decrease whatever may be. So these types of film resistors, we may construct the 10 ohm, mega ohms can be applied. So the more large value can be construct using these film resistors. The tolerance is very less. Then wire wound resistance. Okay, what is the wire wound resistance? Wire wound. Okay, what is it simply? From this the name, the wire is wounded on a helix material, spiral helix bobbin material. Okay, so in wire, the, what is the wire? A metal alloy wire is insulator through a former in the form of spiral helix. So according to this, the material of this alloy wire, we may calibrate the resistance 0.01 to 100 kilo ohms. So these types of resistance mainly use the high temperature area. Okay, so if you use this film capacitor, the previous type of resistance, film resistance or carbon composite resistance, is a very low temperature area. Okay, so if a circuit is working in the high temperature area, we may use these types of resistance. Okay, that is a wire wound resistance. Then last one is rheostat. What is a rheostat? Okay, it is here. What is this? What is rheostat? It is a variable resistance. Okay, rheostat. So now in your lab you are using, varying the current, okay, using the rheostat. There are so many applications, okay, varying the resistance currents using this rheostat. Okay, the same methods of this wire wound resistance. And another types of one variable resistance is a potentiometer. So what is a potentiometer? If you are using so many electronic equipments in our home, radio, TV, and radio, TV, and temperature regulators, whatever may be. So these types of the variable potentiometer, okay, is used. Okay, you see, if you see this potentiometer, it is in the form of a pot. Okay, there are the three terminals is here. One is ground, one is input, and one other is output. Using, okay, when you rotating this knob or rotating this center point, so one contacting area is touching on this, okay, in the etching area of this, the resistance wire, according to this touching area, so in between these ends of these lines, so the resistance value is calibrated. Okay, normally you are using this electrical and electronic circuits, particularly the audio music systems, and nowadays you are using the potentiometer for the toys. Okay, we are using the so many toys. Okay, these types of potentiometers widely used. Okay, what is the physical appearance of this resistance? This is a carbon film resistance. Okay, 4 bands and some types of the special resistance, carbon film resistance having 5 bands. Then variable resistance like the potentiometers. Okay, these are the variable resistance. Then another one is surface mount resistance. It is a modern resistance we mainly used in cell phones or microchips or micro circuits. We are using the surface mount resistance. So what is applications of this what is applications of the resistor? So first, mainly we are using for the current limiting purposes. Okay. Then secondly is for the shunt in the ammeters. Shunt in the ammeters. Okay. So we have studied about the conversion of galvanometer to ammeter, ammeter, okay, galvanometer to ohmmeter. So the resistance part is very, very important. Then multiplier in the voltmeter. Then control the temperature. Okay. To control the temperature or control the voltage drop. So when a current is drop in the circuit, the simultaneous voltage also proportionally drop in the circuit, because V is proportional to I. Then for the purpose of feasible purpose, what is a feasible purpose? In some circuits, generally we are using the fuse. What is the purpose of fuse? If there is any short circuit is happened in the circuit, the fuse will be simply fused. Okay. Okay, for to prevent the circuits, electronic circuit. Here, the feasible resistance is connected in the electronic circuits. If any default is happening in the circuit, the feasible resistance simply fused. Okay, so in this way, the electronic circuit is mainly prevented. And in home appliances, we are using like that heater, iron box. If there is one rotating knob is here, rotating knob is nothing but that is a variable resistance. Using the rotating knobs, the current and voltage also simultaneously changes according to the changes, the heat and the iron box also varied. Okay. Then last one is electronic industries. We are mainly using this resistors. Okay. So in this class, we have studied about the electronics and its components, how they are used in our day-to life, particularly about the circuits, radio and TV, whatever may be, how they are constructed, how to calculate the values, what are the main purpose of the resistor, we have studied about in this class. Okay. And also we have seen about the different types of resistance and their classification of the resistance in this class. Okay. So definitely this class will be useful to you. Okay. Thank you.